A year ago, I made a video about a really unique spreader made by a company called the Andersons. And that spreader's model is the SR2000. I never heard of it before I bought it, and you probably haven't either. But the SR2000 that I featured in that video, I bought at a yard sale. I think I paid $150. I fixed it up, I replaced a few parts, and the spreader's awesome. From the day that I started using that spreader, I had better results. But none of this really matters because that spreader is like about $1,100 retail. So today's video is regarding a new spreader that the same company, the Andersons, came out with. And this spreader is still expensive, and I'm just gonna warn you. So if you are looking for a $50 or even $100 spreader, this is not gonna be the video for you. But if you're curious to see a new product, ever tried an Anderson spreader, you should, because if you're comparing it to the LCO, I think this thing is really better made. I found it to be better. I could have bought either spreader because I had them both at one point, and the Andersons by far won me over. The spreader was given to me for free, so I guess that's, you know, some form of payment. But a year ago when I made that video, nobody gave me anything. I didn't get one product, I didn't get a hat or a t-shirt. I really loved that company's product, and that's why they reached out to me. So today's video is just to show you a fair and honest review of this thing, and we can see what you think, and you can make your own determination. Model is LCO-1000, and I have a link to it below. You can buy it through Amazon, which is another cool part, because LCO spreaders and some of the other brands you can't get online, which kind of stinks. What you're looking at here is exactly what you get in the box. I haven't assembled this, I haven't done anything. There's a lot of bolts and things that are already put together on this, which I think is great. Now, the first negative is I don't know where the instructions went. I think there must have been a sheet with this, but there's nothing here. So all I've done is take this stuff out of the box and lay it out just like you've seen it. This is 100% stainless steel construction. If you don't know what this is just a cover. And these are useful because if you ever wanted to put fertilizer or a product down when it's raining, you would normally think you couldn't do that. But what you do is you fill up the hopper, put this right over the top, and now you can spread because your product is completely dry inside. And it really doesn't matter generally if you're gonna spread in the rain, because a lot of these chemicals need to be watered in anyway. There's no manufacturer in the world that recommends leaving any product in this thing when you're done. If you leave chemicals in here, you're gonna end up rotting the unit out. When I first saw this thing, I thought this looked so much like the Scott spreader at like Home Depot for $30, and I said, what a piece of junk. But when you get close to this, this plastic is extremely thick, but this thing doesn't move. So there's no flex to this, there's no give. The tub alone is really well made on it. This is not anything like the LCO. In fact, it's really easier. And remember, all this was assembled. I didn't have to put any of this together. You just get a simple knob and you can adjust this of where you want it to go, and then you just tighten it. And you've got settings here, and they may cross-reference charts, so if you're gonna try to match other spreader settings, you can do that. What I'm basically gonna use is a regular adjustable wrench. I've got another adjustable, which I featured this in a bunch of videos. I like these. These are Nipex wrenches. They're really handy. So I know that this is the back of it. You can kind of tell just by looking at it. We've got four of one size, two of another, and I've got some cotter pins of different sizes and some bolts. So we'll figure this out. Now, one thing about spreader wheels is you got to check them, because sometimes tires and rims can be different depending on the model. But it looks to me like both of these are identical. Here we go. This handle can be adjusted a little bit. And this looks to be identical on both sides to me. So I'm going to attach this, and I'm sure that we're going to have to put this little pin in here, because the way you calibrate this thing is down here, and there's a little nut that you can adjust right here. In the bottom here, this is the whole impeller for these. Put this in. Clever design. They have a little clip and it holds it. So what you do is you keep your hopper door closed, and now tells you right on the key here it says use its setting E. So I'm going to slide it to where the E and the arrow line up, tighten this up, and now I'm going to open the hopper door like this. And you want to make sure that you do it a couple times to make sure that it's open properly. You can see that there's a little gap there. And all you're going to do is take this key that's kind of like a half circle, and you're going to see if you can press it in. And this fits in with just a tiny bit of resistance in there. And that's exactly what you want. There is a full calibration procedure that you can follow in the manual, and it involves kind of undoing stuff and then resetting everything from zero. But in my experience, what I'm showing you is really all I need. Great, and in 2 seconds, I've got this thing calibrated. If you are looking to step up your lawn care game and you want to get a really quality piece of equipment, this is definitely a great choice. It's cheaper than the SR2000, it's more expensive than the LESCO, but I think the quality is quite a bit higher too. And the biggest thing is the precision and calibration. If you're calibrating your spreader and you're spreading sheets and plastic and all that in the lawn, that's great. It is the best way to do it. But for your average person and even a lot of commercial folks, they're just not going to do that. So this key design here is worth really the price of the spreader, because if your spreader is accurate, then it's going to do a good job. And if it's built to last, then your investments is going to be around for a while. So I hope this gave you some good information about some possibilities around a spreader. And again, I was provided this free of charge, but it didn't make me like it or hate it any worse. I already loved their other model, so I knew that I was going to be very excited to try this. And it's really fit the bill because it is less expensive. Now, I think it's obvious that I really liked the spreader, which is no surprise because I loved the SR2000 a year ago when I tried it, and this really is like the baby brother, but it's no slouch on features. It's super solidly built, and it's really accurate, and that's what matters. So if you're in the market for a spreader and you want to get one that's a really good unit that's commercial level quality, this is it. And if I was picking between this and the LESCO, this would be my choice. So I hope this video was helpful. If it was, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already for more videos coming soon. Thanks for watching.